Right, and let's go on to breaking news coming in. Politburo member of the CPIM, Sitaram Yechury, who you can see on your screens right now, has spoken to the media saying that the government has imposed a ban on the Maoists to clear the ambiguity as regard their status. Yechury also said that in the past, on two occasions, the Prime Minister has called the Maoists the greatest threat to India's internal security. Now saying that it is the government of India that has imposed the ban, and they've done it because they want to clear the ambiguity as far as the Maoists is concerned. He also said that in the earlier ban, it was the CPIML, the PWG and the MCC. Now they've combined together.
Is there a difference of opinion here?
No, you see, the question is that the government of India has imposed this ban. And they have done it because they said they wanted to clear an ambiguity. Because earlier in the list of the banned organizations was the CPIML, People's War Group, and the MCC, Maoist Corps. Now, both of these have merged together to form the CPI Maoist. So, since that ambiguity is there, this has been added to that. Now, the point is that at least on two occasions in the recent past, the Prime Minister has gone on record to state that Maoist violence is the single gravest threat to India's internal security. Now, all of us, everybody, I mean, wants India's internal security to be strengthened and beefed up. Now, the government is privy to the information they have on the threat perceptions. So, on that basis, they have taken an action, and this is applicable to the whole of India. And Bengal is part of India. So this is something that that will be in the natural course of the law of the land. I mean, that will have to be taken up. And I think the state government is meeting today, I mean, the state cabinet, and they will take the necessary call.
But the CPM is quite clear from Prakash Karat's comment yesterday that you're not really in favor, that you believe politically it should be solved,
no,
this
no.
problem.
You see,
but
the,
now the West
no,
Bengal
no,
government...
No, no, no. Point is, please understand, we have always maintained that the problem has to be tackled with on the basis of a dual strategy. One is that it has to be a political solution, because ultimately the most enduring solution will only be a political solution. But wherever there is a breakdown of law and order, or wherever the civic administration is paralyzed by their activities, there it is the fundamental duty of any government to restore civic administration and normalcy. For that, you will require to treat it as a law and order problem. So both these things will have to be combined.
So the West Bengal is just, the government is justified in sort of saying...
Well, let us see. I mean, as I said, it's not, the ban is not confined to Bengal alone. Ban is for the whole of the country. And the state cabinet is now meeting, they'll take the necessary decisions.
No difference between the CPM and...